so many things we have to do to prepare for Kenya.
Eleasa, what are you doing?
Kim, get up. We have to pack. We're leaving in like a month.
A month?
Yeah.
30 days. That's heaps of time.
But if we're going to be in Kenya for 4 weeks, there's heaps of things we have to bring.
Really?
Good thing I'm so on top of things. Here, you should take a look at this map of Kenya. I'll show you.
Okay.
So on Saturday, October 24th, we'll be landing at the airport here.
Oh, Nairobi. It's the capital of Kenya. I wonder if we have time to tour around there when we land.
Oh, don't forget, someone from Africa Inland Mission is going to pick us up and take us to the guest house. And we're probably going to need the rest since we'll be taking a bus for like 7 or 8 hours to get to Kapswar, where the hospital is.
Kapswar? Here says it's a rural village in the Marakwa region of the North Rift Valley province. It's at an altitude of 7,800 feet with lots of good hiking trails. I think it would be a good idea to bring a pair of hiking boots. Let me write that down.
Like these?
Whoa, you are so prepared. What else are you planning on bringing?
A jacket. Since we'll be there from October 25th till November 23rd, it'll be autumn, so it'll be warm in the daytime but chillier in the evenings.
Okay.
Hey, Kim, where are you going?
Check this out. Don't I look so cool?
Why are you wearing scrubs?
Well, let me tell you more about the Kapswar Hospital. It has 140 beds and is staffed by 2 medical physicians, 1 surgeon, and over 100 other staff. So we'll get a chance to assist in surgeries. That's why I'm wearing these scrubs.
Oh, that's true. But don't forget, one of the most important things we'll be doing is talking to the patients and taking their histories.
Okay.
Here, let me practice on you.
Okay.
Enimwa kifwa?
What's that?
Oh, I was just trying to practice a little bit of the local dialect. Let's ask our audience. Does anyone know what language I just spoke? Oh, I see a hand there. Pastor Ben? Yeah, it's Swahili.
Whoa, how does he know?
He's super smart. Anyways, taking patient histories is really important, but since a lot of the patients will be speaking Swahili, we'll be relying on the nurses a lot to help us. Let's all learn Swahili together. The word for hello is jambo.
Jambo.
And the word for thank you is asante.
Asante.
And I think it will be really important to know how to say where's the toilet. I'm going to look this up. Kim, what are you doing to my elbow?
I'm just practicing. Since we will get a chance to do suturing, plastering, and dressing rooms.
Okay. So, Kim, I think I need to wear something underneath my clinical coat in the hospital.
You think?
Of course!
Yeah, so last night, I prepared 2 outfits. And you have to tell me, which one do you think is more appropriate?
Ooh, that's tough.
Let me ask the aunties because they're very wise. So, which one do you guys think should be more appropriate for the hospital? The liberal one? Or the conservative one? Huh? Okay.
So, Eleasa, according to the aunties, the conservative one is the way to go. Not those. Because even though the culture is changing in Kenya, women still need to dress more conservatively. So that means wearing skirts or dresses that go past the knee or trousers. Oh, and don't forget not to wear sleeveless tops or shorts even when you go exercise.
Oh, that's good to know. To bring these textbooks with us.
Why? Why are you bringing such heavy books with you? Are you gonna study there?
Actually, they're not for me. The hospital just opened a new nursing school last year, so I think these textbooks will come in quite handy there.
That's a good idea. Oh, we should bring some medical supplies for the hospital too. I think I should make a list of what they need.
have a sleeping bag. What am I gonna do?
Don't worry. The house we're staying is next to the hospital and it's usually for medical students and visitors. And it's fully furnished with bedding, utensils for cooking, and drinking water. It's pretty well maintained.
Phew, that's good to know. Wait, does the house have bed nets?
Bed nets? Are you worried about malaria?
Yeah, I actually already got the bug spray with 99% DEET. And I have the drugs for malaria.
Whoa, calm down there. Malaria is actually not that prevalent in the capsule because of its high altitude. However, it is a good thing that you're so prepared, my friend. And don't forget, we've got some vaccinations for some of the diseases that are prevalent there, like yellow fever, polio, cholera, and TB, so we should be fine.
Is it gonna be like this over there with no electricity?
Don't worry, there is electricity in the hospital and the village. It's just not always reliable. It's a good thing that you're bringing a torch though. Very good idea. Okay, it's time to get back to my blog.
Blog? What blog?
Oh, I started a blog for our time in Kenya. I want people to know what we're doing and learning there.
So you're saying there's a computer there and internet too?
Yeah, there's a computer in the medical library at the hospital, and it'll cost about 500 Kenyan shillings to use the internet.
500 shillings? That's a lot of money.
Don't worry, 500 Kenyan shillings is only $8.33 Australian. And we'll be needing to use shillings when we get groceries in the village.
True that, true that.
And the most important thing to bring is...
The Bible!
Yeah, there'll probably be opportunities for us to offer spiritual support to the patients and as well as pray for them.
And maybe even read the Bible with them. Yep, I guess that's everything.
And we're ready to go.
Bye.
Action.
Oh, we better not get these textbooks. I think these textbooks would come in handy.
That's a good idea. I think we should also bring some medical supplies with them.
Us. I will make a list.
We start with making a list of what they need.
One more time.
Thank you. So.
Yeah, I actually already got the bug spray with 99% DEET. And I have the drugs for malaria.
Oh.
What was that?
Oh, it sounds like you're joking. Sorry.
Shit.
Whoa. Oh.
Malaria. And cut.
Oh, this way?
Yep. And action.
And the most important thing to bring is... the Bible!
Yeah, because there would probably be it.
And the most important thing to bring is...
Forget that we've got some vaccinations for the disease that are prevalent there, like yellow fever, TB, cholera.
Okay.
Is that polio?
Yeah. She combined two of them. Polora.
Sorry.